الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. My dear respected listeners, inshallah, today we want to have a look at an interesting session or stage in vision development in this episode 27. In our earlier episode, we talked about the various stages in developing our vision, more especially our vision for spiritual development in this 2019 Ramadan. The first stage we described at the visualization stage, which enable us to completely be able to design our ideal future that we want to fight from now to achieve. Then we came to the second stage, which is internalization, to be able to convince all the stakeholders in our life, our mind, our heart, our soul, our body part, and all the stakeholders, the internal or those directly that we have control over, to be able to convince them to buy into this particular vision, which we call internalization. The critical tool we mentioned over there was tahajjud. In this episode 27, we want to quickly have a look at this very important and crucial stage, that is what? Strategy. We all agree that normally, when there is lack of resources, and then when we are yearning for higher productivity, both in quantity and also in quality, if we want to avoid wastefulness or extravagance and we want to increase productivity, then definitely we need to strategize. One of the traditions of Allah Azza wa Jal, Sunnatullah, is strategy. For example, in Quran chapter 54, Surah Al-Qamar, verse 49, Allah Azza wa Jal says that inna kulla shay'in khalaqnahu biqadar, that verily we, Allah Azza wa Jal, have created everything, or we create everything with ordained measurement. If there is no strategy, there is no plan, then we cannot talk about measurement. Measurement is a tool to actualize plans and strategies and visions. And for that matter, that gives us the idea that Allah Azza wa Jal definitely plans for everything. He created all the resources. And then he can just say, kun fayakun. He says, إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. When he wishes for something, it's just for him to say be and then it is. If Allah will plan, then what of us who have no resources? And then who have more limitations in resources? It means definitely we need to also plan. Also in Surah Al-Furqan, Quran chapter 25, verse 2, Allah also tells us that وَخَلَكَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ فَقَدَّرَهُ تَقْدِيرًا, and that he created everything and he ensured that he gave ordained measurement to whatever he created. So my dear brother, my dear sister who is listening to me, we cannot just think that we want to achieve A, B, C, D without planning. We cannot just think that we want to achieve A, B, C, D without critical analysis of these things, and then to also without serious planning and serious measurement, and then also putting in effort to implement, then we can even get the support of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah Azza wa Jal tells us in Quran chapter 29, Surah Al-Ankabut, verse 69, the last verse, that وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. If we strive in his path, he is going to get us guided. So we therefore need to sit down and then strategize. To strategize, what is it? Strategy contains certain basic features and certain elements, and I'm going to mention them in our next episode. We'll have a look at them. Number one feature of a strategy is that it should be smart in order to make the vision itself smart. So a strategy that is drawn outside a smart vision in itself, that feature of smartness that gives the vision that feature of smartness. And what we mean by the smart is that the strategy should be specific. It should be measurable. It should be attainable. It should be realistic. And then it should also be time bound. All these things, when you look at, there are several places we can extract these things. Though in management and in business, in so many personal development experiences, expert, they've been quoting this one. But we are going to have a look at it from the perspective of the Quran. So that is the S of the strategy. Another S of the strategy from the perspective of Islam is that strategy should not be a self-centered. That tool that should help you to achieve whatever you should achieve, it should not make your vision a self-centered in such a way that when you are dead, that vision gets truncated. No, the strategy should help you in a way, it should be designed in a way that whether you are alive or you are not alive, you should be able to achieve it. Our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, during the battle of the trench, when he got down to break the stone that all the companions could not break, anytime he knocked the stone, the light that came out of it, he would say, I have seen the key to the conquer of and such nation. Then he kept on mentioning it, and then the hypocrites were laughing. You can't protect Medina and you are thinking about all this. And how can you do that one? And indeed, those places he mentioned, he could not conquer them. But then his students, his disciple came and did that one. Your vision that you are going to draw a strategy for, it should not be in a way that when you are not there, then the vision or the strategy gets the vision truncated. It shouldn't be in a way like that. Our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one day was seated with his companions, then he took a stick and he drew a rectangle and asked them, what is this one? They said they don't know. Then he drew a line out of the rectangle with an arrow sign. He drew other smaller lines from down to hit that particular line. Then he asked them, what is that? They said they don't know. And he said, the whole of this line represents your life. It represents your life. It has some unique boundaries and some specific lifespan. You will die and go. But that arrow at the middle is your aspirations, your vision, which never will get finished even when you are at the time that you are going to die. That is the way our vision should be. When we die, they should not die. That is the way our strategies should be. When we die, they should not also die. It should continue from this particular hadith that our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam is teaching. Then he said, the smaller ones over there are the other visions and strategies of other people. If you are not careful, they knock you and they change the direction of your vision, or they even reverse you totally. So let's be mindful of the other visions of other people within our environment. In our next episode, we'll have a look at the T of strategy. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala.